Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net, and today I'm just doing some of the normal things I do as a reminder to myself of what needs to be done every year and every couple of weeks. One of the most important things to do when you're planting peppers is to protect them from cutworms. Cutworms will come along at night and you'll be sleeping and you'll come out in the morning and your whole pepper plant will be down because a cutworm has chewed it off. The easiest way to protect your pepper plant is to take a toilet paper tube or a paper toweling tube, cut it about in half for a toilet paper tube, cut it in half, cut it open, and have some masking tape. Put it around your plant at the bottom. Now, I usually snip off the first two leaves, and then I collect them. I do not leave them on the ground. That's like an open invitation. Oh, eat here, eat here. So what I do is I then tape up the tube, jiggle it in a little bit, and believe it or not, that will protect your plants from cutworms. I often will do it on eggplants, and you can even do it on cucumbers. And I haven't had a whole lot of trouble with them with tomatoes, but peppers for sure. As I was planting my tomatoes, I sprinkled dry powdered milk around each plant. And I did that because milk, believe it or not, fights viruses and fungus, which are very harmful to your tomatoes and they are very susceptible to it. So if you protect them from the beginning and keep protecting them about every 3 weeks, you shouldn't have a problem with that. So, off my cage. Take a handful of dry milk, just instant dry milk. Doesn't matter whose brand it is. And that's it. About every 3 weeks. Another thing I do is put my grass clippings around my tomato plants. I put them around everything if I have enough. And that is to keep the weeds down, and I also pull weeds when I see them before I do this, and then split a nice handful around, maybe 2-3 inches. And you will renew this as the grass clippings dry out and they get thinner. You can add more grass clippings to it. Just don't use grass clippings that have recently been fertilized or have weed control in them. You have to wait a couple of weeks after that happens. Yesterday, as I was working in the garden, an experienced gardener stopped and we were talking about problems that we have in our gardens and pests and rabbits and deer and things. And he doesn't have netting around his plants, but he uses habanero peppers. He said that that will stop any mammal from chewing on anything. Doesn't stop birds, doesn't stop insects, but it stops mammals, maybe even raccoons. And what you do is you take your habanero when it has its peppers and you grind them up in your food processor, make them into a solution with water, and then you just put it in a little hand sprayer and spray them on the plants you don't want eaten. Yes, you have to do it after a heavy rain, but it will protect them. And he said it even seemed like the rabbits, once they knew it was on there and they tasted it, they don't go back. So I'm going to give it a try. He even gave us one of his peppers to start with, and I just have to get my cone around there. Grow, little pepper. I also remember to plant sweet alyssum or some flowering plant that will attract the bees to your garden. This is a purple sweet alyssum. I even mulch around that just to keep the weeds down and the moisture in. And then you want to always have marigolds in your garden. bad insects don't seem to like those, so they are our friends. Plus, they're very pretty. They add color to your garden. Another garden reminder is to take the heads off of plants that have already flowered, like our beautiful tree peony. We bought it in full bloom. We got to enjoy it for about a week, and now I'm going to cut it down to the first leaves, the first main leaves, because you can see it's going to seed. I don't want the seeds of the peony. I want the roots to get firm and strong. So again, I'm just going to chop it off. Do not leave these next to the plant. It's an open invitation for anybody that likes to chew on peonies. Now these are old daffodils. Again, I want the energy to go to the roots, the bulbs, not the seed heads. A friend of mine also left me a message that when these are done, if you don't want them in your garden looking ugly, you can take them in little bunches, more or less, bend them over, put a twisty around it. That way they can still get the green energy coming from the sun, but they don't take up a lot of space in your garden for other things. When you're planting trees, you need to get the water to the roots, and you need to do it often so they don't dry out. This is a root waterer. The water comes out at the bottom. So you take it, you stick it down into the roots, turn it on, you can hear it, you can see it bubbling away. Perfect for the trees. Another thing I often have to do, and I'm glad to do it, is to make sure the water in the bird bath is clean. Clean out the seeds. I mean, if it's too scummy, just add some new water. Birds don't like scummy water, and you won't get any friends. Hummingbird feeder. They only like it for about 2 weeks, and then it's lost its potency, and they don't like it anymore. So if you want hummingbirds, you have to change the food in there. Dump out the old stuff in the sink so it doesn't cause ants, and put some new 4-to-1, 4 parts water, 1 part sugar, into your feeder. One of my subscribers wrote and said that they were having trouble with raccoons. And we noticed that when we moved our garbage cans out away from the house, we too had trouble with raccoons at night. So we came up with a bungee system to hold them in place, and for the most part that does it. As far as keeping them out of your garden, deer netting won't work. They're too rough on it. You might want to try the pepper spray. You also might want to try the invisible fence, which is a rotten egg concoction that smells bad to us, but it goes away, but it stays with the plant for at least a month. That could be another way to use them and try to outsmart them. Something to remember is if your garbage or what they consider food is near your garden, you're inviting them over there. And when they get done with your garbage, they just go right over to your garden for dessert. So for that case, you may have to actually build a whole structure and fence in your whole garden like a wrestling cage. You can use a sturdy 2-inch metal fencing like this, and you'd have to totally enclose it because they can climb. I had a question about how to grow potatoes. Now, I've only done it once and I was fairly successful. My thinking on it, I haven't done any research, but my thinking on it is you have to have very loose soil. So that would be with a lot of peat moss, a lot of sand, so that the potatoes don't have any obstructions with their growing. They all would seed potato. Get a quality seed potato from a garden center and use that to ensure that you'll have good potato growth. Don't forget the compost. For those of you that don't have a big garden or even any garden space at all in your home area, you can always use a container garden. I hope we've inspired you to use them. I'm growing thyme here. I've even got strawberries, and I'm growing carrots in that one just to see if they'll grow better. So you can not only use containers for flowers, you can use them for vegetables. You could put a tomato or a pepper or some beans, some onions and chives and parsley in containers. They work very well. A further garden reminder is that if you do have vegetables that you could share, that's the most wonderful gift you could give to a food bank, to neighbors. Don't let it go to waste in your garden or on your table. Give it away. Make someone happy and healthy. I hope these garden reminders were helpful for you and that you have a successful garden, very productive, and have enjoyed the experience of gardening. If you have questions or if you have tips for me that will help me because I've done something terribly wrong, please contact me. I'd love to hear from you. Send pictures too.
And what's your email address?
My email address is lynn@wisconsingarden.net. Bye for now.